Hi there, my name is Adam, and my goal for today is to provide you with a deeper understanding of contact statuses in Elastic Email. We will walk through all of the statuses available in both products. Contacts stand out as perhaps the most crucial aspect of your email marketing strategy, as our collective goal is to engage with an active audience. The specific statuses assigned to individual contacts are crucial in identifying the most engaged users, ultimately determining the type and relevance of emails sent to them. In Elastic Email, we currently support 9 different statuses. The status dropdown offers status filters that show only the contacts with the particular statuses that are selected. Don't worry if you don't have all the statuses in a particular list. It might simply mean that no one has unsubscribed from your list or complained about your emails. Among them, 3 are classified as deliverable statuses. This indicates that these contacts are unblocked and regarded as active by our system, allowing emails and campaigns to be sent to them. Users classified as engaged are those who have interacted by either opening an email or clicking on links within the previous 6 months. These individuals are your most prized contacts. With send time optimization enabled in your campaign creator, our tool can optimize delivery to them. For further insights on campaign creation, click here. Whenever you upload new contacts or manually add them, you can assign status by yourself. The default status for contacts without a history is active. Remember that if you are adding or uploading contacts with an active status, you must confirm that the contacts have consented to receive your communications. Learn more about uploading contacts here. Contacts marked as transactional have chosen to receive transactional emails exclusively and have opted out of marketing emails. A transactional email is an automated message sent in response to a particular action or event distinct from promotional emails that target a wide audience for marketing goals. It's personalized and directed to an individual recipient based on their specific interaction or request, like a purchase or creating an account, and sent immediately by API or SMTP. Only emails identified with the isTransactional=true parameter will be directed to contacts with the status transactional. Want to enable users to opt into transactional emails only? Explore this article for detailed instructions. Contacts with suppressed statuses are prevented from receiving any emails. These contacts are present in both products. If a contact status is invalid, it means that an email sent to them resulted in a hard bounce error, indicating that the email address either doesn't exist or is permanently unavailable. For further details on bounce categories, refer to this guide. Another status is unsubscribed, which occurs when a user opts out of your email list. The only method to revert this status to active is when your contact chooses to subscribe again. You cannot manually alter this or update it with the next contact upload. A comprehensive dashboard with details concerning unsubscribers is available. Here you'll not only find the reason, but also the method and specific contacts that have unsubscribed. A complaint status indicates that the contact has flagged emails from you as spam or junk in their email client. This individual may also claim that they never consented to receive any email communication from you and that the emails sent to them are unauthorized. This status cannot be overridden manually. The inactive status may be assigned if you upload contacts containing role addresses such as marketing@elasticemail.com. This status is also applicable and can be modified later if you want to temporarily suspend sending emails to this contact. The stale status is associated with contact pruning configurations. When contact pruning is activated, any contact surpassing the set limits of unopened emails is categorized as stale. Learn more about contact pruning settings here. Maintaining the hygiene of your contact list is crucial, and contact pruning helps automate the process of eliminating contacts that are not engaged in opening your emails. When employing a double opt-in web form, you might notice the status not confirmed. This indicates that the contact has subscribed to your list but has not confirmed their subscription by clicking the activation email. The status of those contacts will only change once they click on the activation link. You can manually adjust the status of the majority of your contacts by locating them within any of your contact lists. Upon selecting the contact, choose More Actions, Change Status from the drop-down menu. This way, the status of a given contact will be overridden on all lists. But remember that 3 statuses cannot be changed: Complaint, Not Confirmed, and Unsubscribed. These depend on specific user actions, and there's no way to change them in the app by yourself. Keep in mind that even if you re-upload those complained, not confirmed, and unsubscribed contacts with a different status, they will retain their previous status regardless. So if you attempt to switch the status from complaint to active through re-uploading, it will not succeed. During the upload process, duplicate contacts will be removed to prevent unnecessary account usage. Once the campaign is sent, you can explore detailed statistics in the results section, including essential metrics like open rate and click rate, along with the total count of unsubscribers, complaints, bounces, and suppressed contacts. For additional information on crucial email marketing statistics, explore this source. Improve your sender reputation by regularly managing your lists. Before each send, it's crucial to remove any invalid contacts. By prioritizing email list hygiene, you can minimize spam rates and maximize open rates. If you aim to re-engage inactive users, consider launching a win-back campaign. Segment your audience according to their inactive account status and try to re-establish connections by offering exclusive offers or discounts. If there's no response, it suggests that these users may have lost interest in your newsletters and campaigns. And that's all for today's video. If you have any questions about contact statuses, feel free to reach out to our customer support team. If you're interested in discovering more about contact lists and segments, drop us a comment below, and have a great day.